Hello? Hey, Norgay! Subwoofer is calling. The song is...
Give that wolf a banana.
Bọn có muốn một quả chửi không?
Oh, let's adjust this.
It is time to listen to one of the most talked about songs of Melody Grand Prix. Subwoofer is here with the song Give the Wolf a Banana. Now, you could say this is a joke entry. Reading on the WeWe Blog's website, I have their official bio. They say, Subwoofer, the biggest band in the galaxy, first formed 4.5 billion years ago on their home planet, the Moon. Since then, the brothers Keith and Jim have conquered the music scene on every planet, making them the most successful pop group ever. And they say they want to go to Eurovision because they want to perform at the most important and prestigious musical event in the history of the world. Now that may actually be true. In any case, should we listen and react? Let's do this! All right, hitting play.
The lion sleeps tonight. Woo!
Not sure I told you, but I really like your teeth.
Oh.
That hairy coat of yours.
Hairy coat? Ooh, it's a wolf.
Not sure you have a name, so I will call you Keith.
Keith.
This is very sweet.
See where you're going, but I don't know where.
Okay, Shawn Mendes is in the woods.
Is that saliva or blood dripping off your chin?
I like this.
Wow, okay.
And before that wolf eats my grandma, gives that wolf a banana. The wolf wants the banana on the dance floor.
And before that wolf eats my grandma, gives that wolf a banana, give that wolf. Give that wolf.
Okay. This is very funky.
This is like a playful joke act. We can't decide whether it's Keith or Jim.
Yum, yum, yum. Mmm, grandma tastes
or
good.
Or blood or saliva on your chin.
Meat on your breath. Grandma tastes the best. The lyrics are clever, they're witty.
This is a really weird lyric.
I usually don't like
it's
vocoder
got that
effects,
subwoofer.
But because it's a wolf,
wolf,
I like it.
Wolf. Yum, 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 yum. You know, if you don't pay attention to this, then you're 13 years old.
This is anthemic, this part.
You can vibe.
There's bounce, there's thrust, there's drive.
I just think that other acts are making much more of an effort. Ooh. Okay, we're at that karate moment.
This is
now.
Primal, the caveman.
It'd be like kung fu fighting.
Ooh, ha, ha.
Whatever.
Before that wolf eats my grandma, give that wolf a banana, give that wolf.
If that wolf eats your grandma, give that wolf a banana. You know what?
I don't know how you recreate these sounds live, but I like the rhythm. You could see this having epic staging.
Someone give that wolf a banana before that wolf eats my grandma. Life changing.
I love this part.
I like your teeth.
Yes. Hey Keith. That is very sensual, that ending. Ooh.
That hairy coat of yours with nothing underneath. Boom. That was a careless whisper at that end. It was like, where are you going with this?
Okay, first things first. There are, of course, rumors that this group is affiliated with or is, in fact, the brothers of Ilvis, the brotherly duo that gave us the 2013 viral hit, What Does the Fox Say? Like that, this is cute, unique, eccentric, different. A part of you would be like, is this cringe? But you're like, actually, no. I think it's fun. I think it's cute. I think it makes me smile. I like that it's a clever retelling of Little Red Riding Hood. Everyone knows this story, like across so many cultures, particularly in Europe, and the retelling of it is just so inventive. You know, I was recently watching a masterclass by Margaret Atwood, and she suggested, she was like, it would be amazing to retell the story of Little Red Riding Hood from the perspective of the grandmother inside the stomach. Like, ooh, it's really stinky in here. Why does it smell? Oh my God, can I get some space? And I feel like they're doing that in their own way. Yeah, the lyrics are funny. I like the meat breath. Lord knows I've had a pepperoni sausage delight pizza from Domino's recently. I had that meat breath myself and it was delicious.
There's been rumors that an established act is behind this track. You know what? I'm judging the track. And at this point, it needs a lyrical overhaul. Beat-wise, it's on point. Does it get me moving? Yes. Does it get me shaking? Yes. If I'm paying attention to it, does this move me in the same way? No, honey, it doesn't. It doesn't.
Yeah. Anyway, staging. Staging will make or break this. I think that if they are Ilvis, they actually can sing live. People forget this fact that Ilvis can sing. I don't know if they are Ilvis, by the way, but assuming that these two can sing, then it's very promising because the staging could come to life with light effects, with wolves, with forest, with, oh my God, it could be epic. I'm loving this like fairy tale dance floor fantasy. Yeah, some people will find this super annoying.
No, honey, it doesn't. It doesn't.
However, I think staging done right will give this polish and sheen. It actually is very polished for what some would consider a joke entry. Like, this is well produced. This is not cheap. So often joke entries are cheap. This is a smooth joke entry, and this would get a lot of attention if it went to Eurovision. I haven't heard all the songs, so I can't say if this is my favorite, but of the ones I have heard, this is good. Also, can I just say, when they appeared at the MGP 2022 press conference with those yellow masks, I was LOLing. Some of you have said on Twitter that they remind you of Daft Punk. Others were not actually convinced that they were wolves. You thought they were other creatures. Point of story is you can read a lot into them. Like, you see them and you want to know what's going on. If you want to learn more about Subwoofer, you can visit the Weeby Blogs website. Our Rinska has written a post where she lists 6 clues that may suggest the group are in fact Ilvis. Among other things, she points out that they're represented by Universal Music, the same label as Ilvis, despite the fact that Subwoofer has no following. So it's like, why would this label take them on? She points out that the brothers in this group have a similar height difference to the brothers in Ilvis. And she points out that this is in a similar genre of humor as the brothers Ilvis. You may remember that they previously recorded a tribute to the Norwegian diplomat Jan Egeland, and they traveled to Kyrgyzstan to try to break through the country's local music industry. So point of story is, this song is in keeping with the humor they've demonstrated in the past.
I'm gonna check out Pinterest, and I'm gonna go check out Wolf Kingdoms. I wanna see and figure out, do wolves get on with raccoons? Do they get on with foxes? Do they get on with your pets? How are wolves around goldfish? You know what? Pinterest is a good starting point for this. And whilst you're on Pinterest, check out Weeby Blogs, because we are turning it up.
Okay, we are not on Pinterest, but we are on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, Twitter. Give us a follow, give us a like. Let us know what you're thinking of Subwoofer and whether you think they deserve a spot in the final. They have it. They're automatic qualifiers. And whether you think they could win this competition, let us know down below. We'll see you later. Bye.